Hey everyone, it's Jen, and I am excited to bring you my first video captured from the Xbox One. So I ordered myself an external flash drive so I could record for longer than 5 minutes, and I'm currently recording the audio with my Zoom H1, and it's taken some fiddling around to get the right input gain level so you can hear my voice okay, but hopefully I've hit on the right thing. This video here is just going to be a sort of proof of concept to make sure I manage to get the video and audio together. What I've done is I've turned the music off so you can hear just the environmental noise and my voice, of course. And I thought what I would do today, just in this short video, is to show you some of my settlements. And I'm going to tell you right now, my settlements are nothing exciting to look at. They are very simple. I don't use any mods or anything like that. I'm still basically on my first playthrough. I finished up Far Harbor last week, and now I'm just kind of mopping up some achievements before I download some mods to use to play with a new character. So this is my main character here. She is wearing the greaser jacket with ballistic weave, so it's armored. I wear the sea captain's hat because it gives me 2 extra endurance. And then I carry around with me Agatha's dress for when I want to switch out to a high charisma outfit. So I usually wear Agatha's dress, black rim glasses, and the Minuteman general's hat to boost my charisma if I want to make sure I have a good conversation with somebody. So we'll walk around for this in a minute. But right now we're at Taffington Boathouse, because Taffington Boathouse is actually my primary location. I have a lot of my companions at Sanctuary instead, so I don't have to listen to them talk to me. I generally do a lone wanderer unless I feel like it's necessary to bring a companion, because they'll have more dialogue to offer. So I just did Far Harbor with Nick Valentine. But I do have a couple of things here. So I have Curie is here with me. And then I have whatever this guy's name is. That's the bottle. What is he called? Buddy. Oh, yeah, Buddy. So I kept Buddy, and I brought him here. And then I've got a junkyard dog here. And dog meat is actually at Sanctuary. I should probably bring him to Taffington Boathouse. So, as you can see, what I did is I just set up guard stations at the opposite ends of the road, and then I got a couple of turrets. This location doesn't really get attacked all that often. Okay, so this location doesn't get attacked too often. So what I did is I built out a little deck here out on the water. And then I set up my clinic and my bar. And then I just got a whole little bar area here. I got my jukebox, and this is where people hang out at night. So I'm going to go ahead and have her cure my radiation for me.
Excuse me. I can patch you up if you need it. For a small fee, of course.
Yeah. See what's wrong with me, doctor.
Tell me your symptoms.
Think I soaked up some rads out there.
We'll clean you up, don't worry. And that's that. Anything else bothering you?
That was it.
All right. Don't ruin my hard work by dying out there.
Okay, so I've got my little little lounge area, and then, sorry, my cat is obsessed with the furry piece that sits on top of my audio recorder. and she keeps rubbing up against it, which I'm sure would be extremely annoying, so I just had to put her away. So I have this set up. It's basically a lounge area. We get the bar, we got a Nuka-Cola machine, we got a milk machine, got a couple of beds here, and some lounging, more seating area. And then upstairs on the deck, I've got more bedding, so more people sleep up here. And I got some nice light at night. And I have these set up with double stairs because I don't know why the settlers don't path very well. So I find double stairs help keep them pathing up and down, so they can get up there to sleep. So I have two shops out here, and originally they were actually on the pavement, but they kept glitching out up there, so I had to move them in order to actually buy or sell anything from them. And then we'll go inside. Hi, Carrie. Hello, junkyard dog. Yeah, you've got nothing to say, do you? All right, so in here, just more lounging areas. I've got a bunch of paintings. I forget who it was I killed in order to get those paintings, but I have them all over my house. All right, and then we have my magazine racks are here. Let me see. I wonder if I have any more magazines to add. Safer way a magazine? No. Oh, okay, so we can add that. I don't think we care about burnt magazines. Oh, guns and bullets. Islander's Almanac, will that go there? Yep. I have two of those. I really need to unload a lot of this crap. Oh, surgical journal. Picket fences. I have quite a few, actually. I think that's it. Okay, so those are all my magazines. So I get spaces for a couple more, and then I've got a magazine rack right here as well. And then I've got my bobblehead station, which I don't have that many. I only have, let's go into first person mode. The charisma, intelligence, speech, perception, repair, and medicine. So I thought what I might do is do a video where I go and grab the rest of the bobbleheads. Alright, so we'll go upstairs. And go back into third. I'm not really a huge fan of first person, so I usually stay in third as much as possible. So up here, we just have a bed. There used to be, I think there's a body under it. Pretty sure there's a body under there. I put the bed in to hide it because there were bodies in this house and I wasn't able to get rid of them. So we just get a bed up here and just more seating. And then, like, I repaired parts of the ceiling just so people would actually be under a roof when they were sleeping. So I didn't do a whole lot with it. Like, there's no third floor. I'll go down here, and then out here are all my stations. Like, I've got my workshop, my chemistry station. Let's see, do I have anything around the back? Electronic. Oh, and I've got my my water purifier inside here. I think I have a generator in there too. And then I've got my weapons workbench and my armor workbench here. And then just some plants growing potatoes, which I actually need to plant.
Seems to be growing well.
At some of my other settlements. So we're gonna grab some now so I can plant them elsewhere. That's it. I don't think I put anything off the back of Taffington. So it's pretty basic. Alright, so let's go take a look somewhere. Oh, I got my pink flamingos. I got two rows of them here. So, alright, so let's head somewhere else. Ooh, Hangman's Alley. We'll go take a look at Hangman's Alley. Hangman's Alley is actually one of my favorite locations in the game. It's like the settlers there always seem to be active and there's like attacks all the time. So whenever I jump in, there's something going on usually.
Who's that?
Okay. So, as usual, there's an attack of some kind happening.
It's coming in pretty good.
I've kind of built up this area to make as much use of the space as I can. So up here, I've got like just a little bedding area, sleeping bags, because they take up the least amount of room. And then I just get random plants and water pumps wherever I can stick them. Scavenging stations. And then I stick like the little cooking area. It's underneath everything.
My back hurts. My feet hurt. Everything hurts.
And grab. I'll just grab everything. So we get like milk. Put up a guard station here, and I have one out here as well, but for some settlers just will not come out here at all. They just won't come out here. So I have a guard station here, but nobody uses it. Like, nobody comes out to it. And then let's jump up here. Here we go. So I just get turrets up here. And then that's the doorway that goes outside. So, and basically that guard pretty much stays there all of the time. And then up here,
farm, not much, but it's,
I've got bedding. How did you guys get up here, huh? You don't belong up here. So we got people sleeping. We got a Brahmin who shouldn't be able to climb stairs like that. And then I've got my merchants up here. I've got clothing, weapons, and a bar. And then this is the sort of lounging area at Hangman's Alley. And then behind shops are some more beds, and these are basically, I think these are my merchants. I think these are both merchants. Actually, no, neither one of those are merchants. So I usually put my merchants in, like, clean clothes and suits and stuff. So, and then I built this area and then pretty much stopped playing the game. So this was all built up, like, over a year or two ago. And I was going to do more decorating and such. And then I kind of stopped playing Fallout for a long time. So nothing else has really been done with it. But I like this location. I just like the look of it. With these tiny little buildings all closed in, hemmed in together. Reminds me of the Back Bay in Boston, essentially. Because that's what it's based off of. I don't know why you would live in the alleyway when there's all these actually empty buildings you could live in.
We had a good supply of clean water. Things would be pretty good.
Now, are you telling me you don't have enough clean water? Let's see. Well, I guess they do need some more water, so we'll put some more water in for you. Stuff though. Where are we gonna stick it? Maybe back here. Oh, there we go. That worked. So that brings them up to 21 for water, and they get 21 people here. And let's see, is the beacon on? Yes, it is. We'll turn that off. I don't think we need any more settlers here. So. Under here, we have a few more bedding here. So you see this guy in a nice clean suit? He's one of my dealers. And then I should look for... I don't see any of my provisioners. Go out this way, see if we can find one of my provisioners. They usually go off down in this direction. So most of my provisioners are dressed up in postman outfits. Some of them wear a postman hat, and some of them wear mining helmets with the light on it. It's kind of cool. Alright, let's see. We'll take a look at one more area. Let's see. I don't know. I really haven't done much with most of these. Let's take a look at Murkwater, and that is one of my raider settlements, which is loaded with people. So each time I come to Murkwater Construction Site, I have the pack here, and whenever I arrive, they have either just killed a Mirelurk Queen, or they're about to. I never have to help them.
Ain't enough places to
Yeah.
Maybe you could do something
I doubt that I can. Because I don't care where you're not sleeping. Okay, so I've got, like, booze and outfitters. Pick-me-up stations. I've got so many guard stations here. Just to put them to work, mostly. Like, I could use turrets, but whenever there's attack, turrets have to be repaired. So I like the pack. I like the way they dress.
Ain't no one sad about Colton.
They look cool.
Just don't screw this up.
And then...
Hey, don't let running
I just... I can't believe there's 25 people here. It's so crazy.
If you can take something, it's yours.
So, pick-me-up station, a booze still. I got my water.
You starving us
yep,
on purpose?
I am. And then we got like a little shack here. So we got a shack with
that
a couple
dominates.
Events. And then in here, what did I put in here? I got the ghoul. Yeah, just threw some sleeping bags down. I got the ghoul chair, a couple of chairs. And then more bedding up here. Get out of my way.
No one's a slave that don't want to be.
And then up here, very precarious, more beds. So, and then I put guard stations up here. Because why the heck not? I basically have spammed guard stations all over this location. Alright, what else we got? Let's see. How many beds am I missing? 3 beds. I need 3 beds, and they don't have enough food. Well, that's annoying. Maybe some of them left. That would be nice. Alright. Let's see if I've got any cloth to make beds. And I feel like by making more beds, I'm just inviting more of these assholes to move in, and then they need more food. Alright. Do one more in here. Here we go. Now they got plenty of beds. Still not enough food, but they'll survive. So that's it for me for now, and then I think the next Fallout 4 video I do, I will go ahead and do the bobblehead run so I can see if I can get those 2 achievements out of the way. Have a great evening.